Hello and welcome. I'm Ben Jenkins. I'm a sales engineer here at Datto. Today, I'm going to introduce you to Datto Siris, our flagship business continuity appliance. And to do this, I'm going to unbox and set up a brand new appliance. So Datto has five different form factors of Siris appliance, and I've actually got our Siris Free X1 with me today. But before we open up this box, let's understand a little bit more about what Siris is able to do. It takes backups of your servers, it stores them on this local appliance, it replicates them up into the cloud and allows you to have rapid, quick recovery times in the event of a disaster. Inside of my lovely little box today, we're going to open this up and you will see I've got a lovely white box at the top as well. Inside of this, I have power cables and I've got a network cable to be able to connect my Siris appliance into my network. And then just below from there, you'll see I have my Siris Free X1. My Siris Free X1 is a full 1 terabyte flash SSD. It allows me to take lightning fast backups and even quicker restores. And you'll see it even comes wrapped, so I can also satisfy, pull that away. We have a multitude of different Siris appliances. As mentioned, there's five different form factors. Now they range from the business, professional, and the enterprise, from a nice little desktop chassis, all the way up to rack-mounted units. Today, as mentioned, we're going to focus on our Siris Free X1. Now that we've got our Datto appliance plugged in and on the network, we can now go to our Datto partner portal. From our Datto partner portal, we can go to status and then BCDR status, which shows us this lovely page. On here, we'll have a list of each of our appliances that we have got access to as an MSP. And we can see that my top appliance has checked in 6 minutes ago. Now, another way that we can find these appliances on the network is by going to a website called device.dattobackup.com. On there, you get a list of each of the appliances that are actually showing on this local network. You can see I've got quite a few here, but if we scroll down, you'll see it's just named backup device, Siris Free X1, which is this appliance that we're showing you today. Now to access this, I just want to click on this IP address here. It's going to take me through to our registration page, and more than likely, it's going to run an update very quickly, just making sure that everything is fully up to date and that it's happy with where it should be. From there, we can see that it has successfully updated, and I'm going to click Next. I can now give this a name, and we're going to call this appliance our test appliance. Underneath from there, I can give this a username, and for the sake of this, we're just going to use Datto. We can then set our own password, which we're going to do so now. From setting up our password, we want to roll through and set up our email address alerts. I'm just going to stick in my email address in here. From there, we can create our client organization that this is going to be assigned to. That's going to be our end user whose appliance this is going to be installed on their site. And we can also set our time zone. For those of us in Europe, we're scrolling down a little bit, and as we're based out of Reading, we're going to choose London. Finally, and one of the most important pieces to set up on this page, please make sure you select the correct offsite data storage location. Here, I'm going to be choosing United Kingdom as I want my data to stay in the UK. I'm then going to allow the installation of third-party software and drivers, just mainly because I want my device to keep getting updates and to stay as secure as possible. From here, I'm going to click Complete Registration, and this can take on average 1 to 2 minutes for this to now add and be successfully registered on our database. Now we can see that our Datto appliance has been successfully registered. We can now very briefly run through the UI of this appliance. Now, what you'll see on my homepage is on the left-hand side, I've got my local free storage, along with what will be in a second, a breakdown of how much space each server will be using on my appliance. As this is a Siris Free X1, you can only add one server to this appliance. Over to the right of there, I've got my replication status, because the Datto solution is more than just an on-premise appliance. We want to make sure that you are truly protected and that your data is off-site at all times. What we're going to do now is actually add a server to be backed up. Now, I've chosen the Protect tab on the top left, and it's automatically brought me into my Protector System Wizard. From here, I'm going to choose my agent-based system, because previous to setting this up, I had already installed the agent on my server. I'm going to click Next from there, and what I can now do is type in the IP address of my server that I would like to protect. So this IP address is 10.200.185.126. From there, I can download a template from the Datto Cloud that I have previously set up to save me time in terms of setting up this agent, choosing when I'd like backups to run, all of that kind of thing that we're actually going to run through today. And what I also have a choice of is, do I want to encrypt my backups? Now for this, as it's a test, I'm going to leave it as no. Obviously, that is totally down to you guys when you're setting up the Datto appliance. From here, we can click Next, and it's going to run through, and it's just going to confirm that everything is set up correctly. From here, I can now set up my local backup and retention policy. And there's two different ways, and we'll run through the first here. I can go through, choose how often I'd like my backups to run. And with a Datto solution, you can go down from hourly to half hour to 15 to 10 to every 5 minutes. Once I've chosen the intervals I'd like them to run, I can then choose which times I'd like them to run. So here I'm running them from 8 a.m. through till 6 p.m., Monday to Friday, and I've also said that I'd like them to run on Saturday and Sunday. Now I can configure this later for even more times. However, right now, I'm gonna have it set for 11 and for 3 p.m. Down from there, I'm gonna leave my retention as the default. However, I can totally configure this and change this to however I would like it to be, so that I can ensure I'm saving this data and storing it locally for as long as is needed. Down from there, I can click Next. And on here, I can choose which backups I'd like to send off-site. I'm going to send off-site one backup every single day. Down from there, you'll see my retention that is already set. This can be defined by the plan that you have signed in with Datto, whether that be 1 year time-based retention or infinite cloud retention, storing all of your data forever in the Datto cloud. You're going to hit Next on there, and then we have our verification schedule. One of Datto's key technologies, screenshot verification, testing that your backup is recoverable in the event of a disaster. Here, you can choose how often this is ran, and I'm going to run this on each point that is offsite. So what I'm seeing here is that each of my backups that are sent offsite will be recoverable, and we can show you that a little bit later. From there, we're going to hit Next. I can then choose my alerting that I'm going to get on my agent. You'll see it's already put my email address in that we selected earlier. And from there, I can choose my individual notifications. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to select all of them. So I get all of the notifications regarding my appliance should I need them. This is all totally configurable at a later date if you would need to change it. I'm going to hit Next on there. I then get a choice of, do I want to save this as a template so that in future when I'm setting up other Datto appliances, if I want to mirror this exact configuration, I can download this down automatically from the cloud. So I'm going to go ahead, click Yes, and I'm going to name it Template 1. From there, I hit Next. I can verify that I'm happy with everything, and I'm going to go ahead and click Finish. What this is now going to do is it's going to contact my server, make sure that everything's okay, and then add it onto my Datto appliance. From here, we can see that it is already added, and I can now click Start a Backup. This is going to force that first backup to our Datto appliance. This first backup is going to be a larger backup. However, everything afterwards is going to be the incremental change from each backup after that. So while waiting on this backup to complete, we're going to jump through and we're going to configure a few other things. First and foremost, we're going to jump into Configure and then Networking. Now, under our Networking tab, you'll see I've got a ton of different options that I can configure here. I've got a lovely connectivity check that's running through here, and that runs automatically for you. However, going down a little bit further, I have my IP settings. Inside of my IP settings, I can set it from DHCP over to a static address. Now, here at Datto, we don't say that you have to put it on a static. That's going to be totally up to you guys, as the main way that you're going to access this appliance is via the remote web, or as we call it here at Datto, Datto's remote web 2.0. Scrolling down from there, I have a choice if I want to bond my interfaces. However, for this moment in time, we're not overly fussed about that. And then finally, we have our DNS settings and our host name. Under DNS settings, we do advise that you put in a public DNS. I'm going to use 1.1.1.1 for this. And then we can just hit apply. If you ever wanted to change the name of the data appliance that we set up earlier, you can see that's just below, under host name. So if you have a bit more of an imaginative name than test appliance, feel free to change it here. Going up from there, we can jump onto configure and off-site synchronization. Now this is a really, really key part of setting up your Datto appliance. Because what this page does is it chooses how fast your data is allowed to go off-site from your Datto into the Datto cloud. How quickly can it upload that backup that you've taken? So we've got our default transfer limit here. That is the fastest that you're saying your Datto can send off-site at any given time. Now, because I know that my upload is going to be higher than that, I'm going to set this to my maximum upload of 1,000 kilobytes a second. I'm then going to hit apply on there, because what I can do as well is, during work hours, throttle this right down. What does that mean for me as an MSP? Well, my end users are going to be much, much happier. I'm going to be throttling their internet on how quickly the Datto can send off site, meaning that they've got much more bandwidth to play with themselves. Here, I'm just going to set that. As I know, they work from Monday to Friday. And they're also in from about 8 until 6 p.m. So I'm going to set this from 7 till 9, just so we get the early birds and the stragglers at the end of the day. So we're just setting it for 7 a.m. all the way up to 9 p.m. And where it says backup app, that means how quickly can this send off site. You also have pause backup, which means it won't send off site at any time during that. So for backup app, I'm going to set this to 200 kilobytes per second. I've hit add event, and that's now populated for me. So what this means is that at the fastest, outside of 9 p.m. and before 7 a.m., it's going to send off site overnight at 1,000 kilobytes a second. However, during that time, when everyone's in the office, it's going to send off site at 200 kilobytes a second. We have taken our backup, we have stored it on that local appliance, and then booted it into our KVM hypervisor that is running on our Datto. From there, we've waited for it to hit a logon screen. And from that logon screen, we've taken a screenshot. That screenshot is nice and viewable here. If I click on the successful, I can see here that it is able to hit that logon screen. And what does this give me? Proof that my server is recoverable in the event of a disaster. It gives me that peace of mind and I can go to bed safe and sound. As mentioned earlier, I can choose to back up my server every hour, half an hour, 15 minutes, 10 minutes, or 5 minutes. So at most, I'm going to lose 5 minutes worth of data. I can also choose at which hour throughout the day that I would like this to run. Scrolling down, I can choose how long to store the data on my local Datto appliance, and I can also choose how long I'd like to store this up in the Datto cloud. I can also go onto my volume level backup control, choosing which disks I would like to back up. For example, do I want to back up just my C and my D drive? But maybe not my E drive. I have multiple verifications that I'm running at the end of every single backup as well. The first is integrity verification. Now, what does that mean? Inside of that, we have three checks. We check that the file system's health looks absolutely fine and there's no corruption. We will also make sure that all the volumes you want to protect are actually being backed up. As an MSP, the last thing you want to do is have to go and explain to your end user that, hey, we're really sorry. I know we said that your C drive and your D drive was being backed up, but we screwed up. We also have a feature called Ransomware Detection. Inside of this, we are scanning for what we believe is signs of ransomware. We have three individual checks that we are running. If any of these checks actually pop up and say, hey, we think there's ransomware, we alert you so that you can go in and double check on the original server. There are a ton more different configurations that we can do on this agent itself. However, we don't have enough time today. The final thing that I'm going to show you today, though, is our recovery methods. So to do that, I click on the Restore tab on the top middle of my screen, and then you'll see my server on the left-hand side. I would just select this, and then I would select the recovery type that I would like to use. I have 9 different recovery types. However, for this example, I'm going to use the local virtualization. I've chosen local virtualization, and I can then go through my individual backups that I have taken. I'm going to choose my most recent backup because let's say, for example, ransomware's just hit my system. I want to recover back to just before it had infected all of my machine. From here, on the left-hand side, you'll notice I've got the RAM and the cores, the processing power. How fast do I want this machine to run? I can also change my networking. I can bridge it to ETH 0, I can bridge it to ETH 1. I can do a ton of different firewall settings, or for just the example that we're showing here, I'm going to leave it disconnected. Now you will notice that I clicked the Start VM button. And because this device is running a 1 terabyte SSD, it is going to be incredibly quick at getting this server booting up and ready. From here, I can click on my screenshot, and then my screenshot is just loading up, and I can actually see here that my server is now at the logon screen. In a matter of seconds, my server that was destroyed because of ransomware, and it could even be a blue screen of death, a hardware failure, any kind of disaster, it is now back up and running on my Datto Siris appliance. All I have to do is log in, enter my password, and give my machine the same static IP address it had beforehand. Further from there, backups will still continue onto my local Datto appliance, because you do not know when the next disaster will hit. Today, I have shown you how to set up your Datto Siris appliance. But what does this mean? The Datto Siris is a solution built by techs to help make MSPs' lives easier. We enable you to save your techs time, whether that through our Datto Partner Portal, managing multiple Datto appliances at once, or even our rapid recovery methods, allowing you to virtualize a server in seconds. Our solutions help automate processes like backup testing so that you have peace of mind that your client servers are truly protected. Thank you for joining us today. If you'd like a bit more information, please do reach out to your local sales rep.